Hi, this is Rhonda, and we're going to talk about using GIMP to modify product pictures for your website, for your labels, that kind of thing. And so right now, I'm going through the large jars. And what I've done already is gone through all of the pictures, and we tried to maintain our fragrance list at around 75. So we have jars, big jars, melts, and refills. And then we also have a specific satin vases and satin sets that are fragrance specific. So we have to go through all of that. And we usually go through, if we're revamping everything, about 1,000 pictures. And so it's near impossible to photograph each and every individual item. That would be mammoth. It would take all year, and we're not just not going to do that. So what we're going to look at, of course, here, right here, you can see the cinnamon, and they all have consistent frames, and they all will be consistent all the way through. Okay, so we're going to leave that alone. All right. We have two layers here in GIMP, and one is the jar, and one is the chocolate label that I threw on there. What I'm going to do is right click on it and delete that layer. So now I have just the jar. I'm going to back over here and take the next photo that's well, here, let's do English Rose. I'm just going to move English Rose and just drag and drop, and it makes a layer all on its own. Now, I have a filter that I like to use as far as like repeat curve bend, but we're going to go down to distorts in the filter, and we're going to look for curve bend right here. And so you can click this automatic preview so you can kind of see it, and you can see it curve and that kind of thing. And so we're going to Let me see if I can cancel this, but this is about what I want as far as a curve goes, right? And I'm just going to cancel it because I have one that is already the way I want it. And so we're going to curve bend this layer for English Rose. Now, you go into the tools, transform tools, you go to scale, or at least I do. And get it smaller so you can fit it into the picture. Now, what I look for in this situation to try to make it as consistent as possible, right, is to get it like right up here and then right at the edge over here. Okay, you can see the edges where the white is and down at the bottom. So we're going to scale it. All right, so it's scaled. We're going to go to transform again and perspective. And this allows you to move the corners individually. And so we're going to cover up the white over there in the corner. We're going to cover up this white in the corner. And I'm going to move it up a little bit here and get it to the side so you have more of a square, because this is actually what it looks like in person. And just up a little bit and kind of like face forward. All right, so we've got a little bit of perspective there. All right. So even though this is not pristine and it doesn't quite look like something that you photograph each an individual item, you have a lot of clarity. It's very bright. There are no shadows. Excuse me. And we could go through it rather quickly. So, excuse me, I am going to go ahead and export it. So go up to File, Export As, and we're going to put English Rose in the jar pictures that I have it already in the file for. Export, and I have the quality at 100%, and export again, and now it's in the file. Okay, we'll go ahead and look at it real quick. Large jars. And English Rose. Let's see if it'll come up pretty quick. So there you go, just a real quick lowdown on how to use GIMP, which is a free program, to manipulate your product pictures. Thank you so much.